So the vital statistics are that when we've modeled putting these batteries together with a specialist consultant, balanced batteries, when we've modeled that in an EV, you've got a 20% saving on the cost of the pack, and also an increase in range of the vehicle. So that's really important.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. I'm joined by Graeme Purdy, the CEO of Ilika. Graeme, good to speak with you. And a significant milestone as the year draws to a close. You've just shipped the 10 amp hour prototypes on schedule. So big move for you.
Well, absolutely. And at Ilika, we pride ourselves in delivering on time and to expectations. And the team is absolutely delighted that we've been able to give our customers an early Christmas present.
Yeah, maybe stronger batteries than they'll need for to power the Christmas tree, though, Graham. So, what's the next major step to move Goliath towards commercial production or licensing?
Well, we'll be working closely together with those customers to evaluate the performance of the cells. It's interesting, actually, in the industry that there are a number of different perspectives on the best duty cycles to test batteries with. So, although we have done an extensive testing program already, we will be learning alongside our customers, and we expect to get some useful feedback that will help us develop even better batteries. Our next milestone is that 50 amp hour cell that we're targeting. And of course, we are opening discussions for tech transfer and further scale up that is likely to be done by our partners rather than us. That's really important to emphasize, is that we have an asset light business model that relies on licensing our technology rather than Ilika itself building large factories.
Graeme, the pilot line hits a 93% yield. How close is that to commercial requirements, and what does it mean for scaling?
But yeah, that's a really great question, actually. And if you speak to people in the industry, they'll typically say that at pilot line scale, where Ilika is, you would expect about 80% yield. And for it to be a credible process that is ready for further scale up. And then by the time that you get to production, you want a minimum of about 90%. So the fact that we've got 93% on our pilot line, I think, is a really great validation that we have a robust process that is ready for scale up.
Graeme, how do the weight and cost advantages of your oxide coating strengthen Ilika's position against established battery markets?
Well, look, we're all dying for better batteries. We want longer range in our vehicles. We want EVs to cost less. And this is the mission that Ilika is on. Irrespective of the fact that this is a solid state battery development program, we're actually trying to improve batteries so that we as consumers have a better experience of using them in EVs and other applications. And so the vital statistics are that when we've modeled putting these batteries together with a specialist consultant, balanced batteries, when we've modeled that in an EV, you've got a 20% saving on the cost of the pack, and also an increase in range of the vehicle. So that's really important.
So what's next, Graeme? What should we be watching out for as the year draws to a close and we head into 2026?
Well, we've also got our second product line, Stereax, which is cooking on all gas rings right now as we head into the festive period. So there may well be some additional news associated with that. And then, well, early in the new year, we'll have a bit of a wrap-up of where we are with our half-year results. Well, I hope we'll get the opportunity to update you again at that point.
I look forward to that, Graeme. Thank you very much for your time today. And if we don't speak again, have a good Christmas and New Year.
Thank you very much, and the same to you and the team at Proactive.
That's Ilika CEO Graeme Purdy.